Every writer dreams of becoming a worldwide bestseller with millions upon millions of books sold, but only a few ever hit that goal. So how do they do it? What's the secret? Well, for all the authors whose stories I've learned, it usually comes down to three elements: hard work and perseverance, innate skill, and plain dumb luck. A huge surplus of any of these without a complete absence of any of the others seems to be an almost surefire formula to join the ranks of multi-mega best-selling authors. So in this series, we'll take a look at some of the most commercially successful authors of the last century and see how these elements combine for them to achieve such lofty status. And today, we'll be starting out with one of the most successful of all time. Stephen King, 350 million books sold. Stephen Edward King may very well be the epitome of a serial bestseller. Having written over 50 books in a career now closing out its fifth decade, every single one of his books has made it onto the New York Times bestseller list. And it all started out with Carrie, his first published book released in 1973, when King was just 27 years old. So it was all sunshine and daisies from the start, right? He obviously isn't going to check high in the perseverance scale, right? Well, not really. King ended up working on becoming a writer, refining his craft for almost the entirety of his life. In his book On Writing, he describes a spike he nailed into his bedroom wall. Every time he received a rejection letter, he would shove it onto the spike. Eventually, there were so many rejections that the spike fell out of the wall, and he was forced to get another one. Before Carrie was accepted for publication, he'd written several other novels, many of which were published in later years, such as The Long Walk and Rage. He also helped supplement a tiny teaching salary by selling short stories to magazines. So he certainly didn't find success extremely early or easily. But with that said, when he was just 27 years old, his first book was accepted for publication with an advance of $2,500 in April 1973. Adjusted for inflation, that's nearly $14,500 today. Quite a windfall for someone who had just barely been scraping by. But that windfall is nothing compared to what happened just a month later when the paperback rights were purchased by New American Library for $400,000. The nature of his contract split that sale evenly between King and his first publisher, Doubleday, meaning that at age 27, Stephen King was walking tall with $200,000. Now that's a lot of money for today, but adjusted for inflation, that's $1.15 million. So while he did work for many years, he was nonetheless a very wealthy man before the age of 30. So for perseverance before first success, I'll just rate him 3 out of 5. But that said, it would have been very easy for him to quit or slow down the pace at such a sudden fortune. Many authors do and become one-hit wonders. He did the opposite, and is today well known for his incredible production. Dozens upon dozens of books have spun together to form this remarkable career, multiplying his success with each new book. So for hard work, I have to bring him all the way up to 5 typewriters. Innate skill. How much natural-born ability is the author working with? This is easily the most subjective category on this list. What is skill? What is good writing? What is a good book? There are no clear rules on any of these things, for it is the essence of personal choice and taste. For many people, many millions of people, 50 Shades of Grey is a damn good book. Now, even though for me it's exactly the opposite, there cannot be any denying that the book, and many others popular derided, have found mass appeal, meaning that for many, many people, it's good. Any book you can pick up and fall into is a good book for you. But not every book is a good book for everybody. So how can I judge good if good is unjudgeable? Well, I'll have to simply go by 2 metrics. 1, critical acclaim. And I'm not talking about professional critics here, people who generally have a bad case of head ass syndrome. I'm talking about readers. What do the people who actually read and buy the books think? What are the reviews on Amazon or Goodreads? And the second way I'm going to judge it is by my own personal experience. I certainly have my taste, but I've read widely, and I will at all times try to force myself into staying fair and see things from others' perspectives. So with that said, Stephen King is working with an incredible amount of talent, and he has been for the entirety of his career. Characterization, storytelling, and the simple beauty of the prose itself, all of them are top-notch. Now, that's not to say that there aren't flaws in his game, because there certainly are. Many of his endings, heck, most of them, range from meh to child orgy, giant spider, teenage alien, silly. At times, especially during the 90s, his books often became bloated, wandering messes with just atrocious pacing. But by and large, he has churned out great book after great book for decades on end. Just take a look at his first 5 books. Carrie, Salem's Lot, The Shining, The Stand, and Dead Zone. Carrie is an all-time horror classic, a cultural touchstone with countless homages. The Shining was adapted into what may very well be one of the most famous horror movies of all time. While The Stand and Dead Zone are both extraordinarily good books, if not quite the cultural significance of other King books, they both got very good adaptations done and they're just good. How many cultural icons Stephen King has produced? Carrie, The Shining, Christine, Cujo, It, The Shawshank Redemption, Misery. You can put a meme up of any of these books and people will instantly recognize them, even if they've never read the book or seen the movie. Which, quite frankly, is extremely unlikely, because each of these books and their subsequent adaptations have achieved cult status, some even surpassing King himself. I mean, how many people actually fail to realize that The Shawshank Redemption even was written by King?
I came around the corner of the aisle and there's this elderly woman who was pushing her cart, and she looked at me and she said, "I know who you are. You write those scary things, and that may be okay for some people. I respect you, but I don't read things like that." And I said, "Well, ma'am, I wrote The Shawshank Redemption and Stand By Me," and she said, "No, you didn't."
For talent, I have to give King 5 typewriters. For the final category, luck, we have to take a peek at the key events that led to the author breaking into the mainstream in a big way. How many lucky breaks did they receive? How many right places, right times? Well, King's had his fair share, and it started with his first book. Although he'd already received a massive payout for Carrie, his career really began to take off when it was adapted into an all-time classic movie shortly thereafter. Sales of his books exploded, and this explosion was made exponential when The Shining was turned into another all-time classic just a few years later. Now, would King have still gotten as popular if his early adaptations had turned out as poorly as many adaptations are wont to do? Well, who can say? Who can also say how much King's solid source material has helped to make the majority of his adaptations at least good, with several of them being near or at great? But the fact of the matter is that Hollywood has only helped to fuel King's cultural and commercial success, with adaptations like Carrie, The Shining, Christine, Cujo, Shawshank Redemption, The Green Mile, It, and so many others. So for luck, I'll give him 4 typewriters. So in closing, how did Stephen King reach the incredible heights that he has? Was it due to his incredible skill as a writer, his lucky treatment by Hollywood, or his endless work ethic and productivity? Yes. Yes to all of them. Stephen King is a perfect storm of hard work, talent, and lucky breaks, and the results speak for themselves. What the ability to churn out so many books has done is to cast a wider and wider net. With over 60 books out there, the chances of a reader just happening upon one are large. And with such massive talent, the chances of that reader enjoying the book and coming back for more are even greater. Every reader he hooks will in turn buy dozens of books, whereas a reader that loves another author who has only written a few books will only be able to buy a few books. Throw in a slew of Hollywood classics to help attract new readers, and you have an unstoppable recipe for success. Talent, hard work, and a fair sprinkling of luck thus combined, and few have ever climbed as high as he, and few ever will. He found success early, and only built from there. So let me know what you think. Do you think I've nailed down the reasons for King's popularity? Or do you think there was something else I didn't mention? I'd love to hear what you have to say. And tell me if you like this kind of content. If so, the next time on How They Got There, we'll take a look at a very different tale. One where an author took a vastly different path to end up among the ranks of the world's bestsellers. So make sure to subscribe to not miss that tale. And until next time, stay awesome.